moments that we will share together. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand with me for the national anthem of Jamaica. To give us the opening prayer.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone. Let us pray. Our Lord and our Father, we thank you this morning. For great is your faithfulness. Morning by morning, we see that. And we have experienced your blessing this morning, first thing, just by waking up. And Lord, we want to thank you. We want to thank you for journeying mercies to gather here to celebrate and to acknowledge and to recognize our achievers. Lord, the hard work that has been placed in this program over the years is nothing of our will, but because of your grace and your mercy and the strength that you have given us. Lord, we pray that you will continue to inspire, to motivate, and to just help us to continue with this program. Father, thank God, we thank you for the persons who administer the programs throughout the parishes and also at our head office. Father, just grant us your mercies, your strength, and all your many blessings on us as we go through. And as we acknowledge our students today and all the persons who will be awarded, Father God, we continue to pray for their strength that they will go through. When we will have left here today, we pray for journeying mercies to return safely to our respective homes. Thank you again for today, and we give you all the praise and all the honor only to you. In Jesus' name, amen.
You may be seated. Thank you so very much, Missel, Senior Parish Manager, St. Elizabeth. Ladies and gentlemen, the person I'm going to invite to come and speak to give the welcome and overview of the path top achievers is one who I have learned had a lot of... See, I caught you right there with a pregnant pause, eh? Did a lot in the early days with PATH and really understand the mission of PATH and guides the ministry as a chief executive officer, so to speak. I invite Mrs. Colette Roberts-Risden, Permanent Secretary of the Ministry of Labor and Social Security, to come, please. A round of applause for her.
I think with a pen in my hand, not with a mic. Morning, everyone. Master of Ceremonies, I'd like to acknowledge the Honorable Pernell Charles Jr., Minister of Labor and Social Security, Honorable Favour Williams, Minister of Education and Youth, Dr. the Honorable Norman Dunn, our Minister of State, Mr. Vernon White, Special Assistant to Minister Tufton, Minister of Health. I see here Denzel Thorpe, but I don't see him. You know, he's coming. The Master of Ceremonies spoke about me being there in the at the inception, but Mr. Thorpe was also there at the inception, designing our first IT system. Mrs. Audrey Dare Williams, Chief Technical Director in the ministry, Mrs. Tamar Nelson, CTD, other senior directors in the ministry, parish managers, staff of the ministry, representatives of the Planning Institute of Jamaica, Mr. Andre Miller, who we cooperate so much with from UNICEF, our PATH Top Achievers awardees, their parents, the teachers, the principals, our trailblazers, other specially invited guests, members of the media. It's a long list. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning again. It's a pleasure to join you as an awardees at this Our PATH Top Achievers Awards ceremony. This is a much anticipated event. Not only is it significant because of the fact that it is the fifth such event we're having, but because this year we not only celebrate the accomplishments of our current student awardees, but we have an opportunity to celebrate the tangible long-term impact of beneficiaries or of persons who were once beneficiaries many, many years ago. This is also our first award ceremony since the COVID-19 pandemic. It is in this spirit that I warmly welcome you to today's event. Ladies and gentlemen, the PATH is in its 22nd year, and it is indeed a pleasure for all of us here today to celebrate the successes. It is especially meaningful to me as I was there at the beginning. In 2000, the government of Jamaica articulated a commitment to reforming its programs to reduce poverty and inequality, and as part of an initiative to transform the social protection landscape in Jamaica. This transformation resulted in the creation of the PATH program and the rationalization of several social programs at the time. The aim of the program was providing financial support to persons, but at the heart of the program is the objective of human capital development as a means of breaking the intergenerational cycle of poverty. And so, Minister Williams, it's very good that you are able to join us today, because it is through education, and I think many of us can attest to that, it is through education why many of us have been able to reach and succeed in life much better than some of our parents or forefathers. Since its inception in 2002, PATH has gained a reputation of being the government's flagship social protection program and has influenced the models of conditional cash grant programs throughout the region and as far afield as the African continent. Over the years, the program has evolved beyond a mere delivery of cash grants to fine-tuning its initiatives in keeping with best practice in social protection. In 2008, we introduced transitional grants to incentivize beneficiary students to continue their education after completing secondary school. That same year, we implemented the Steps to Work program, an initiative providing second chance education, skills training, entrepreneurial support and job readiness to participating families, enabling them to become economically self-sufficient. In 2013, we took it another step further by increasing the opportunities for attainment at the tertiary level for beneficiary students and introduce the PATH tertiary bursaries that provide support to persons who were once beneficiaries of PATH to pursue their bachelor's degree. The Top Achievers Awards event showcases some of our most outstanding students and leaders who have made significant strides towards the economic independence of themselves and their families, with PATH as a strong and reliable system of support. Looking around the room today, I am filled with pride as we acknowledge the 32 awardees who have excelled scholastically at the primary and secondary level. And we have, I think it's 3 trailblazers who have excelled professionally. Today's ceremony will therefore recognize the top performing male and female PATH beneficiary student in each of the 7 Ministry of Education regions at both the primary and secondary levels. A top scholar in each category will also be recognized. We have always known that education opens the door to upward mobility and economic prosperity, and many former beneficiaries become trailblazers in academia and in corporate Jamaica. Our Trailblazer Award will highlight 3 of these outstanding persons. In concluding, I would like to thank the ministry team and our partners who support us in our endeavor to break the cycle of poverty once and for all. Awardees, we are proud of your success. Your success is our success. Your success is Jamaica's success. May God continue to bless you. And may all of you, at whatever stage and level you are in life, continue to reach for higher and higher heights. Thank you.
Thank you, Permanent Secretary, Mrs. Colette Roberts-Risden. The support for the Program of Advancement Through Health and Education is a real thrust, and it of course calls for interministerial support. Of course, education is in the name of PATH itself, and this morning we have the pleasure to be in the company of the Honorable Favour Williams, Minister of Education and Youth. Please make her welcome as she brings greetings.
Good morning, everyone. It's great to see you. Is that Principal Grant right there? Hi. Let me begin by acknowledging colleague ministers, Honorable Pernell Charles, who is the main minister today, the Minister of Labor and Social Security, and with him, the Honorable Norman Dunn. Let me acknowledge as well Mr. Vernon White, Special Assistant to the Honorable Minister, Minister Tufton, P.S. Risden and the team, the entire team from the Ministry of Labor and Social Security. Let me acknowledge as well my own team from the Ministry of Education and Youth, not just the central ministry, across the regions, and I see some of my principals here and teachers this morning. All the mommies who are here, raise your hands. Mommies, grandmommies, daddies, granddaddies, uncles, aunts. It's great to see all of you. Let me acknowledge the awardees and, of course, the media. Thank you for always being here to help us to carry the news, the good news of what this government is doing. So as Minister of Education and Youth, I'm delighted to extend hearty congratulations to the awardees of the PATH Top Achievers Award 2024. Highest commendations are also in order to the Ministry of Labor and Social Security for this initiative, acknowledging the hard work and dedication of our PATH beneficiaries. Today, 32, and I'm using the number that I heard the PS said, because I had 29 in my speech, but 32 awards are being presented to students who've demonstrated discipline, hard work, and a commitment to excellence through their performance in the primary exit profile, PEP, and the Caribbean Secondary Education Certificate, CSEC. The Program of Advancement through Health and Education, as you know, was established way back in 2002 with a primary objective of breaking intergenerational poverty by increasing educational attainment. The government continues to provide support for children from our most vulnerable households through PATH, and this has enabled our students who might otherwise not make it to be able to perform well in national and external exams. At the Ministry of Education and Youth, we take our jobs seriously in terms of implementation of the PATH grants that come to us on behalf of our children. And most of that goes through our schools, and so I want to acknowledge all the principals who are here, because it's on the ground that the real work happens in terms of ensuring that all the beneficiaries have access to what is being provided for them. The circumstances of your achievements, speaking to the awardees, makes it all the more important and remarkable. I also take this opportunity to extend special commendations to the recipient of the PATH Trailblazer Award. Going forward, I urge you to explore your potential for greatness through technical and vocational skill area, academia, sports, entertainment, science, technology, engineering, art, mathematics, or any discipline you choose. With the same tenacity and rigor you applied to the exams. To the parents, to the teachers, to the guardians, I thank each and every one of you for your individual input, and I congratulate all the recipients again on your achievements. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Minister Williams. Interestingly, the Ministry of Labor and Social Security is my favorite ministry. And it's not because they've asked me to host. I mean, that deserves a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Many years ago, I got the opportunity to host an event while I was, I think it was in first year. And I was able to grow with the ministry. And many of the things I've learned from that time, not being a beneficiary of PATH, but a beneficiary from those who help to make PATH move every day. And so I'm owning this event as a top achiever as well, being able to host this event coming from so far. But the Ministry of Labor and Social Security, to me, is a bedrock ministry of our nation that Jamaica hasn't really understood as yet. Because in my mind, without social protection, there can be no elevation. And if there's no elevation, you can't really have a fully successful nation. Am I making sense? So the hardworking team that goes to the Ministry of Labor and Social Security every day to work in the interest of Jamaican people, I applaud you. I'm not the only one with a testimonial. We have some testimonials for you. And I'm going to ask you to turn your attention to the screens as we hear from some of our PATH beneficiaries.
Hi, my name is Alyssa Farmer. With the help of the Board of Family and Medical Support, my assistant and I will be attempting to obtain the degrees and degrees each year. Now, this is from primary to high school, including sixth form, and that's approximately 13 years in all. PATH not only helped there, But after completing my CSEC and CAPE examinations, and I did great, of course, I was actually able to obtain a scholarship that definitely assisted me financially in university. My family and I are grateful to PATH for all the help that we received. I endorse the PATH to transformation.
Good morning. My name is Dr. Makeda Bailey, and I come from very humble beginnings. My father, a farmer, and my mother, a stay-at-home mom. Love them both dearly. I ended sixth form knowing that I wanted to study medicine, right? However, having come from very humble beginnings, there was that financial burden on my shoulder, wondering if I could afford the tuition. But glory be to God, I was granted the PATH scholarship, and it aided phenomenally in me completing medical school. I was able to take less student loans, and I have less money to pay student loan and more money in my pocket, and I was able to go through medical school without having that financial burden, you know. And I'm just extremely grateful to the PATH committee and for the help that they were able to provide in letting a little country girl's dreams come true. So I fully endorse the PATH to transformation.
Yeah, good day. My name is Ramon Thomas. I'm here to tell you guys that I'm a proud beneficiary of the PATH program. This program have done a tremendous job for me and my family over the years going to the Portmore Archers NTA. And in addition to that, the PATH program has also done a tremendous job for me as well by granting me a business grant. This program did such a good thing for me when I was training at the Art College of Construction Service in Portmore, where I was doing a welding level 3 and a diploma in drywall construction, which they gave me $600 Jamaican per week. It was tremendous for me during those times of difficulty when there is no help. My family could not give me any support. The PATH program helped me a lot. This benefit that the PATH program gave to me has done so much for me, including at this moment speaking to you guys. I'm currently in the UK working as a skilled worker in welding and pipe fitting. I endorsed the PATH program in Jamaica doing such a wonderful job, and hope they could do this for many more young youths.
Good day, everybody. Greetings to all. My name is Zachary Campbell, and I am a final year electrical engineering student at the University of Technology. You know, PATH has always been a very integral part of my scholastic journey. You know, my earliest memories of PATH dates back to high school, where I benefited from various initiatives associated with PATH. For instance, the lunch program, and also being able to do all of the external exams that was required for me to transition from one stage to the next. You know, PATH was also instrumental during my time at university, where the substantial fees associated with, you know, going to school was greatly alleviated by me being recipients of grants and various scholarships under the Ministry of Labour, associated with the PATH program. And that's why I am fully endorse, you know, the PATH to transformation.
Okay, so there might be a space of background noise. My name is Brittany Monroe, and I'm here to talk about how PATH has helped me in my journey of becoming a pharmacist. And today's I can't forget receiving the acceptance result, and my aunt would always paid for school fees and all that. She came to me and she said that she's not sure if she'll be able to help in the way that she always has been able to help. So immediately I knew that I had to go and sort scholarships, and I did a good amount, I think a handful, and I just remember receiving an email from PATH, and they were the only one to help fund my journey. So
I endorse the path to transformation. Story of PATH benefiting them and allowing them to lead better lives. I can tell you that Whenever you see the results of the hard work, you can say it's worth it. Every day that you put in, Mrs. Risden, it's worth it because the Jamaican people are benefiting. I'm going to invite someone to deliver his remarks, one who is also passionate about the path to transformation. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. the Honorable Norman Dunn, Minister of State, Ministry of Labor and Social Security. Make him welcome.
You see, I'm the short one, and so I have to adjust this. But good morning, everyone. Minister, I must tell you, when I walked into the room this morning, I was like, wow, you look great. Please give yourself a round of applause. Mr. Master of Ceremony, the Honorable Pernell Charles Jr., Minister of Labor and Social Security, the Honorable Favour Williams, Minister of Education and Youth, Mr. Vernon White, Special Assistant to the Honorable Minister Tufton, Minister of Health, my own Permanent Secretary, Mrs. Colette Roberts Risden, Mr. Denzel Thorpe, is he here? Is on his way still. My own CTDs, CTD Dear Williams and CTD Tamara Nelson, other senior members from the ministry, our parish managers and staff, and I see one of my, I would have said one of my favorite because I might get myself in trouble. But I see all my favorite managers from across the region, including Montego Bay. Where's my St. Mary? Can't leave that one in the hall. You know, that's my parish, right? Of course, other representatives from the Planning Institute of Jamaica, representative from UNICEF, PAT, top achievers and trailblazers, parents, principals, specially invited guests, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen, good morning again. You know, reflecting on the journey of the Program of Advancement through Health and Education, PAT, we see a vivid illustration of our government's commitment to uplifting the most vulnerable persons amongst us. And you just saw testimonials from persons. And those testimonials are real. They're real. And sometimes persons, Minister Williams, believe that nothing will go on in Jamaica. That is a lie. That is a lie. So, the program, of course, was born out of a vision to create a sustainable safety net that not only addresses immediate needs, but also to foster long-term social development. It is a vision that recognizes the intrinsic link between health, education, and economic prosperity. And for persons who don't know, I'm a pharmacist. So I was so happy when I saw the pharmacist and her testimonial. Since the inception of the program in 2002, PATH has been a cornerstone of our social assistance effort. The achievements that we will witness here today bears testament to the program's resilience and the collective will of our nation to ensure that no one is left behind. This is the country we're building. The support from our international bodies, such as the World Bank and the Inter-American Development Bank, has been instrumental in this journey, enabling us to to expand our reach and to enhance the impact of our interventions. Ladies and gentlemen, as I reflect on my own upbringing in rural St. Mary, I'm filled with a profound sense of appreciation for the significance of PATH. My mother, a hard-working market vendor, endeavored tirelessly to provide us with wherewithal in those days. In those days, Minister, programs like PATH would have been a lifeline for my family, offering a glimmer of hope amidst the challenges. It is through divine grace that we are able, and we were able, to transcend those circumstances. The personal journey underscores the transformative potential of social programs such as PATH, which empowers individuals and families to change their narratives. The evolution of PATH over the years highlights the remarkable story of adaptation, and improvement. Successive administration have recognized its value, building on the foundation to enhance service delivery and expand the scope. But as we look to the future, my message to you, awardees, today is one of service and gratitude. We must stand on the shoulders of those who have paved the way for us, benefited from their sacrifice and dedication. You are indeed a product of service, shaped by your contributions of countless individuals who believe in the potential of this nation. The legacy of service is not a debt in the traditional sense, but a moral obligation, a call to action that resonates with all of us. It compels us to look beyond our individual aspirations and work towards a greater good, ensuring that the benefits we have enjoyed are extended to others. So, as you will hear later in this ceremony, our trailblazers, our nominees, have attained points in their own career where they're already making significant contributions to our development. Thank you, nominees, for blazing a trail for your youngsters to follow. You have done us proud. To our young awardees, the day will soon come when it'll be your turn to contribute and to give back to your communities. I charge you to continue to emulate the examples of resilience, sound moral character, and success that you are being modeled, and that are being modeled for you here today. The Trailblazers nominee are from backgrounds similar to yours, similar to mine, and they all have made it. So can you. So I'm proud of each and every one of you. Ladies and gentlemen, today we celebrate success and excellence and look forward to many tomorrows when we'll be able to celebrate greater social and economic development of our beloved country, Jamaica. Today, we can build a Jamaica that is not only prosperous, but also compassionate, where every citizen has the opportunity to achieve their fullest potential. Congratulations to the awardees. Congratulations to the parents. Congratulations to the teachers. And congratulations to the persons who have paved the way for all of us, that we can stand on their shoulders here today. Good morning.
Minister Dunn, I'm not teasing, but I'm just raising it back. Thank you for that inspirational message, Minister Dunn. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now move to the part of the program that most people like, and it's not the lunch. We're going to be hearing a very special rendition from a very special person, soloist. Her name is Althea. I must tell you, in my four steps that I made up here, I forgot the last name. But that's okay, because I'm on the path to achieving better memory too. Ladies and gentlemen, we will move to lunch, but while we get prepared for that, we will hear from a lovely songbird, Althea. Please make her welcome. And while they come, it seems I will need another microphone.
Oh. You can manage with one.
We'll try.
All right, good, good.
Ladies and gentlemen, I don't even know what time it is, but it is good to be here. Ministers, I'm following you around, so I'm associated with Power 106 FM, which is at the back there. But I'm not on that duty today. I'm on singing duty, because when Mrs. Bolt Williams assigns me a task, I do not say no. My name is Althea McKenzie. I host Farm Talk on Power 106 FM. This is my friend Rochelle Daly. We both sing with the University Singers. And we were tasked with finding songs that would inspire our young people today. I don't know which one the sound man has lined up. One of them starts with just one note. So we'll see what happens. We don't know which one we're getting. That's why we're looking at each other. So whatever they give us, that's what we're going to sing. Very we'll wait. Start it again.
Thank you.
And can you bring the levels up for us, please?
I have often dreamed of a far-off place, where a hero's welcome would be waiting for me, where the crowds would cheer when they see my face, and a voice keeps saying, "This is where I'm meant to be. I'll be there someday. Can go the distance and I'll find my way. If I can be strong, I know every mile would be worth my while. When I go the distance, I'll be right where I belong." Down an unknown road to embrace my faith, though that road may wander, it will lead me to, and a thousand years would be worth the wait. might take a lifetime, but somehow I'll see it through. And I won't look back. I can go the distance. I will stay on track. No, I won't accept defeat. It's an uphill slope, but I won't lose hope till I go. Broken down and tired of living life on a merry-go-round. And you can find the fighter, but I see it in you. We gotta work it out. Move, mountain. We gotta walk it out.
You.
times again and we'll rise up.
Another round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. I especially felt that you know. It really traveled through my nervous system. Thank you so very much again for those wonderful items. You know, you're multifaceted when you're a host and a singer and all these wonderful things. And of course, singing with the university singers do set your part. Thank you so very much. I'm going to invite someone who has taken on the mandate. And this is just me reading the newspapers, you know. Taking on the mandate to ensure that the path for transformation is not only theoretical but demonstrated. I've seen this person across the island doing a number of consultations, meeting with the people to hear from them how they are being affected and how they're receiving the services of the Program of Advancement Through Health and Education, and of course hearing how he or the team can improve it. This is none other than the Minister of Labor and Social Security, the Honorable Pernell Charles Jr. Please welcome him as he comes to deliver the keynote address.
You have to move it down.
No. Thank you. What a good morning it is. You sound afraid of it. I want to, of course, acknowledge our Master of Ceremonies. He's doing a good job. He's connected to the Ministry of Labor and Social Security, and I believe that he will continue to be connected because he has done a satisfactory job so far, I must say. I would like to acknowledge my colleague Minister, Favour Williams, who, based on the program, I actually told her that she could step out while we do lunch and come back. But then, things happened and I've been asked to speak before lunch, which I think is better for me because everybody will probably be asleep after lunch. But I acknowledge her and acknowledge my brother and friend, Dr. the Honorable Norman Dunn, Minister of State in the Ministry of Labor and Social Security, and also a very inspiring young man, I must say. You should say thank you for calling you young. My permanent secretary, well, Mr. Vernon White, firstly, who is, where's Vernon White? Yeah. Vernon White? Yes, I was assuming. Mr. Vernon White, representing the Honorable Christopher Tufton. Mr. White, I'm going to have to speak to you after. Because the minister says that you're bringing some money for the ministry with you today. Yes? We'll have that conversation. Don't call him to confirm, though. Just have the conversation. Mrs. Colette Roberts-Risden, our permanent secretary. Mrs. Audrey Dare Williams and Mrs. Tamar Nelson, our CTDs, and other senior directors who are here. parish managers, staff of the ministry who are here, as well as other ministries. I'm hearing teachers and members of the Ministry of Education and Youth are also here, as well as Mrs. Colette Robinson and Mrs. Shelley Ann Edwards of the PI Planning Institute of Jamaica, PIOJ, Mr. Miller, most importantly, our PATH top achievers who are here. Can we see your hands in the air? Top achievers scattered across the room. Wonderful. And our trays. Just checking if you know how to say it. You see that? Yeah, that's good. Trays bladers. I'm just kidding. Where's your hands? Trays blazers. Only one? I know there are others. Another? Anybody else? Three? Okay, all right. Parents? Yes? Principals? No? Teachers? You're not a teacher, sir? You're a principal? Yes, principal. Any other principals here? Yes, okay. Especially inviting us, all of you, members of the media, everybody. It's really a good morning. You know why? You know, the real essence of this country's development starts here. And I say it all the time, and I truly believe it. Being given the opportunity to serve in a leadership space at this time in Jamaica is moving in a direction and at a pace that I perhaps didn't think we would achieve during my lifetime. And when you think of all that we've gone through in the last 4 years with COVID, to see our country being able to shift our conversations and our arguments to things that really reflect that we are developing, the fact that we are not leaving behind and that we are not forgetting the importance of the equitable society that we're trying to seek is critical. And so being here today, let me acknowledge our CTD Jennings, who happens to look like one of the PATH top achievers, and so she wasn't acknowledged before. But what we're doing here today is more than just giving out awards. You see, the goal is really to encourage the entire nation to acknowledge the importance of pulling each other up. Jamaica is an amazing country. We are an inspiration to so many others through our music, through our sports, through our personalities. We have made an impact on so many. I was walking on the street in Chile, Dr. Dunn, Chile. And I had asked somebody to carry me to their equivalent of a flea market, a market where you could get to see their own items, local items, get a feel of their culture. And I'm walking in, and I see somebody selling items from all over the world. So they had four big flags and then a number of other small flags. They had the American flag, British flag, some other flag, and a Jamaican flag. And I walked over to the person thinking this was a Jamaican, because why else would you have a massive Jamaican flag in Chile? And just to understand, it's not a Jamaican. But when she realized I was a Jamaican, boy, it was like I became the center of attention of the entire market. And they wanted to know everything. And it really just over and over and again hits me of the immense power of who we are as a people. And a big part of that is the stories like that of our trees. I'm just testing you again. Trailblazers. and other Jamaicans who have made it. My father would often remind me, even though every time I tell this story, I have to say that my grandmother challenges it, but he often reminds me that he used to walk to school barefoot. And that when he started school, secondary school, is at the age when I was ending secondary school. And so the opportunity gap just between that generation is massive. What he went through, what my mother went through, which was perhaps even more challenging than him, the massive gap, but they were able with support to be able to provide all opportunities for the next generation. That is the goal of PATH. Breaking the intergenerational cycle. And when we say of poverty, it's not just economic issues. It's all of those other issues that arise sometimes that are inimical in terms of challenging our society. And I'm so proud of the Ministry of Labor and Social Security, because this ministry, the people's ministry, is set up to treat with the most vulnerable, those persons who need the help the most. Those children in our early stimulation program who sometimes are not understood, but then when you get to know them, even in the wheelchair, even those who cannot communicate with you, you appreciate how intelligent they are. Those senior citizens who you walk into the room and you sometimes think that they are mute. When you give them 10 minutes and you start to receive gems of information. And our PATH beneficiaries, those who often believe that they will not make it because of the circumstances, and they often believe that they shouldn't make it because of the circumstances. But then they interact with somebody at the parish office who says, don't worry, we're going to help you. And I know social workers in this ministry who take out of their own salary. I'm telling you. I know social workers who take out of their own pocket. I have social workers who, before I was minister, have called me and instructed me to help and demanded and gotten help. And I'm proud of them, because their job, their role, their responsibility goes way far past the terms of reference. And that love, that caring, that giving is why we are here today. Education is critical. And I want to pause and just acknowledge Mrs. Bolt Williams, who I'm sure took so much time to write this amazing speech. At some point, I am going to look down. Please, because I glanced a while ago and she looked at me like this. So I know, you know. I'm going to read at least two words out of it. Our nation's most outstanding scholars. But my point is this. The aspect of education is so critical, because as we always say, education is that great equalizer. And I often remind my children that no matter what happens to me, once they receive a foundation, they can be anything they want to be. But so many children do not get that opportunity naturally, easily. It doesn't come as a matter of their circumstance. And so we have to step in and have a deliberate, targeted approach to provide that support to those children and to those families. The PATH program, or PATH, is Jamaica's flagship program. It is our primary way of stepping into that gap, of ensuring we create those linkages, of ensuring that we provide that pillar of support so that our children will be able to get that help to learn, to achieve. And just watch the videos. I wish you all could have been at the last town hall. I commend it to you that whenever we're doing these town halls, just click the link and watch it. We had 3 testimonials at that town hall. I think 90% of the room was bawling when Zachary was talking. When we heard his testimony, the loss, and then when he spoke of his triumph, that's when we understood the linkages between where you are and where you can be and how you get from there to there. Minister of Education and Youth, we want to thank you and your team for the partnership that we have between our ministries so that we can provide support for our children, for them to realize their dreams. And we are going to strengthen those partnerships with the overhaul and the review that we are going through now, with a view to ensuring that we address the challenges that have been exposed and revealed. So we provide a system that gives maximum support to our children. For this year, we are working with a particular theme, celebrating empowerment through education, because that is what we see in our top achievers. Children who have risen above circumstances, who have utilized the opportunity of education, and are now moving towards success. As we all know, success is a journey. It's not a destination. It's something which is consistent and constant in its calling. And so, along your journey, top achievers, we come together to recognize you, to recognize your parents, to recognize the stakeholders, all who have contributed to the 29 of you in primary and secondary school being here today. All who will continue to push you towards your tertiary education or towards whatever it is that you see as your field of choice. And we want today to be an example. We want it to be an encouragement, a motivation to others looking on to say, I want to be a top achiever. I want it to be jealous. They must want to get the award, because the goal for us is to continue to stimulate the minds so people understand that the hard work is achieving some kind of positive result. So we hail you. We acknowledge the hard work that you've put in to be here. And I think that it is fitting for us, ladies and gentlemen, to give our 29 top achievers a round of applause. Now, the 3, because you heard our permanent secretary speak of 32. As a mathematician, I quickly called over Mrs. Bolt Williams. I said, but hold on. The 7 regions, we have a male and a female winner of each region. 7 times 2 is 14. So that's for primary. 14 times 2 is 28. How do you get 29? Because apparently we have a tie in one of the regions, correct? Yes. So that's 14 plus 15 is 29. Huh? What? Your mother, what? We are live. This was both, we're live on streaming, you know. Oh, I can't say that. Oh, and let me just say clearly for all who are watching that I am, that this YouTube stream is free of cost. If you know, you know. Novia, please, don't. My team is very worried about me because challenges run off my back. It doesn't bother me. All right, yes, so 14 plus 15 is 29, but then where does the PS get to 32, right? 32 minus 29 is 3. And that remaining 3 are for our 3 nominees who are our, say it with me. I really want to say thank you to you. I don't know what's going on with me in that word. For those 3 persons, and we want to, I just want to say something about our Trailblazers. It's the first time I've gotten it right. I mean, come on, guys. Thank you. I like that side of the room right here, yes? Now, when I'm speaking about the encouragement, these are the individuals who have gone through that system and have already achieved in the primary and secondary level and have now excelled in their academic and career pursuits. And they're looking back so that our top achievers can look on them and say, I want to not just be a top achiever, but I need to be a trailblazer. And at every step, at every stage, PATH is creating these opportunities for motivation so that ultimately we can have a program where if you're in the PATH program, you should feel confident that you're getting support that is resilient. You should feel pleased. You should feel positive about where you're going. And this is the goal. This is why we have spent the time to put all of this wonderful ceremony together. And I want to say to the 3 of you, congratulations. We consider you as leaders of today and tomorrow. And we definitely want to say that our nation is benefiting from you already. And I look forward to your contribution to the program. I am going to ask that our trailblazers, perhaps we need to have some kind of alumni of trailblazers, just like you have the Rhodes Scholars, so that over time, as they excel, they remain connected to PATH. This is a really amazing program, doing really big things, and we want to make sure Jamaica is aware. And let me close down, because I'm smelling food, which means that perhaps the lunch is now ready. And I'm seeing Novia, so that means that food is here. I'm CTD, Dear Williams. This is me now reading the last paragraph of Mrs. Bolt Williams' speech. The stories of triumph and challenge fuel my commitment to lead a transformation that will ensure that the program is fully equipped and effectively serve our most vulnerable citizens. Our goal is to create a more responsive, a more transparent, and a more efficient and effective PATH. And we want to ensure that the more than 300,000 beneficiaries are all achieving, all top achievers. We're confident that when we have completed our overhaul, when we've gathered all of the evidence and information, that we'll be able to design an even better program. And I want to tell you this. You know, I was confronted by someone in the media when we first started to speak about the PATH review, permanent secretary. And they came to me and said, Minister, you said that something is wrong with the program. Tell us all of the things that have gone wrong and why you have to fix it. Right there and then I smiled and I say, you know, that's one of the main problems with how some of us think. We believe that something has to be so terribly wrong for you to evaluate yourself to improve. If there's one thing that I was taught, is never believe you reach so far that you can't have an introspective look on who you are to be better. The PATH has done very well. Look around. But we want PATH to continue to do well, and we want PATH to do better. And so, just like you are driving your vehicle, you have a nice vehicle, and you're going to say to yourself, every whatever period of time, you're going to do your service, we're servicing PATH. And when we don't service it, what should come out of the garage is a brand new 2025 PATH top vehicle. And when we hit the highway with that, we're supposed to be speeding through. Not like that black Benz that went over the thing. But we're supposed to be moving smoothly. And those who are occupying that PATH vehicle should feel better, stronger, more enhanced, more confident about the success of their own individual journey. And that's the goal for myself, for Dr. Dunn, for Permanent Secretary. We want to have, and we want to celebrate the transformative impact of this program. Let me just close off by expressing my gratitude to our PS, our CTDs, and the entire team of parish managers, of the officers, social workers, and all the others, anybody who contributes to this program. Let me state it categorically. As we go through this process, we want to hear from everyone. We want to hear from our principals, from the officers and nurses in the health clinics, our guidance counselors. We want to hear from past PATH beneficiaries. We want to hear from present, current beneficiaries. We want to hear from Jamaicans who have a contribution to make, whether it is on social media or otherwise. We want to hear from you. And whether it sounds good, I say this all the time, or sounds bad, share your view so that we can consider it in this review. Together, let us continue to work hand in hand, building on the successes of this amazing program, so that we can forge a brighter, more inclusive future for this country that we love. A future where everyone can thrive and everyone can have an opportunity to contribute to our nation's prosperity. Congratulations to our very, very proud parents who are here, and guardians and grandparents. Congrats to our achievers. Congratulations to our trailblazers. And again, thank you to all of you who are here, who have contributed to the success of this program. We really do owe you a debt as a country, because a lot, as Mr. Danvers said, a lot of what this ministry does was not being told, but we're telling it now. One love.
Thank you, Minister Charles. So yes, Minister was reliably informed by his sense of smell that something is brewing. It's now time for lunch, but just before, for those who are watching online, thank you so very much for joining us. I want to make special mention of our media partner today from the RGR Gleaner Communications Group, Pro 106, who is streaming live. Thank you so very much for joining us for this momentous occasion. I also want to let you know that we are streaming on the Ministry of Labor and Social Security's YouTube channel. So if you have those family members abroad who want to tune in to see that your, you know, your top achiever is doing well, it's a good time to log on to your YouTube. There's internet in here to just click that link and share with those to have to be a part of that experience. Now, there's another experience I'm going to expose you to whilst we get prepared for the meal. There is a musical presentation that I'm sure you will appreciate This time it's an instrumental by a saxophonist. His name is Deshaun Fender. Interestingly, his claim to fame isn't that he's a saxophonist, but that we went to high school together. Calabar at that. Yes. So that is his claim to fame. That is his claim to fame. That we went to Calabar together, and we, of course, suffered some losses recently, but we will be stronger. I promise you, we will be stronger. Right. Because the utmost for the highest. Ladies and gentlemen, he will be making his debut from the floor so that you can get a chance to touch and feel the music a little bit better. Deshaun Fender, a saxophonist. Make him welcome.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you so very much, Deshaun Fender, saxophonist. I want you to know that the applause are we're a little bit dwindled now because people still have knives and forks in their hands, eh? Did you enjoy the meal, ladies and gentlemen? Was it good? Absolutely, absolutely. I really did enjoy. Ladies and gentlemen, we have come to the point, or the part of the program, that we have all been waiting for, when we will recognize the PATH top achievers from across the island. I must tell you, the decisions were difficult because we had to search through the information to find those who are doing incredibly well. As a matter of fact, you heard earlier that so many persons were doing well that it was a little bit difficult to come up with who's at the top. And that's a good problem to have, don't you think? Indeed. Now, I spoke earlier about the interministerial relationship with the Ministry of Labor and Social Security and the Ministry of Education. And one such person who have allowed us to get the information in a very efficient way and timely way is Mrs. Stacy Witter Bailey. Stacy Witter Bailey, where are you? Are you this right here, sir? Thank you so much. Put your hands together for her, please. Because it is with your help we were able to get the information on the different students and their scores, etc. So thank you so very much for your hard work, and we tremendously appreciate your efforts in that regard. Deputy Chief Education Officer with responsibility for the examinations. There you go. See, I get big up. Indeed. Now, earlier we heard from the PS, Mrs. Collette Roberts-Risden. We heard from Minister Favour Williams, Minister of Education. We heard from both ministers, Minister of State and Minister. I almost said, Minister who is senior, but that would be a little bit conflicting because it's Pernell Charles Jr. But we heard from both ministers, and we've had lunch. And we're at a point where we will be presenting the awards. But my producers came to me and told me that there is someone in the audience, a recipient, a top achiever, who doubles her roles. She's not only an academic, I was about to say professional, not only an academic doyen, but she's also a songbird. And she came with the ambition to do a little song. And PATH is about giving people chances, not true. So I'm going to invite her to come up. Madam, please, do come. Hello, what's your name?
My name is Candestina Mendez.
Calestina? Candestina. Mendez. That's an interesting name. Who named you?
My father.
I see. I'm a little bit fearful to ask what his name is. I'm a little bit fearful to ask what his name is. But I see, that's a beautiful name. And which school are you from?
Old Harbor High School.
Old Harbor High School. All right, good, good. I see my friend Tiffany, who's from Old Harbor and did very well there. Journalist from the RJ Argina Group came in. Okay. So I hear that you're a songbird, right? Is that true?
Yes.
Good. Are you in the choir at school?
No, I'm not at the choir at school. I'm a solo singer.
Oh, and I hear somebody say you sing in the church.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Well, Candestina Mendez, so break up in syllables, eh? Will be doing a song for us. Ladies and gentlemen, never before heard at a function like this, Miss Mendez.
I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me. All my days have been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head Oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire in darkest times. You are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend. And I have lived in the goodness of God. Sing, everybody. It's all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I know you all know this part. Yes. 'Cause your goodness is running after me. 'Cause your goodness is running after me. When my life laid out, I surrender now. I give you everything. 'Cause your goodness is running after me. One more time. 'Cause your goodness is running after me. 'Cause your goodness is running after me. When my life laid out, I surrender now. I give you everything. Oh yeah. 'Cause your goodness is running after me. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I'm gonna sing of the goodness of God. Yes, I'm gonna sing of the goodness of God. One more time. I'm gonna sing of the goodness of God.
Very good.
You never know where she's going to be in 10 years, you know. So no, go on. She'll remember me.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us today. And please have yourself a wonderful afternoon. But after that, what should we have next? Wow. Wow. Why part of everybody? Pharmacy, singer, doctor, lawyer, everybody. You can imagine if there's a state of emergency, just say coffee pot people. Them can run the country in a time of emergency. Beautiful, beautiful. A product of the Old Harbor High School. Wonderful. I can tell that she sings in the church, you know. Because when she got to the high note, something inside of me was telling me to tell her to go on. Mercy. Woo! The church people, them start, I got nervous in a PS. Because I see a sister over there, so I start jerk 2 times, and I said, Lord have mercy. It's a prayer session, it's going to break out. And I see minister walking in. Let me behave myself, because I'm online. No, I'm not getting into that. I'm not getting into that at all. But I'm going to invite Mrs. Marcia Bolt Williams to join me on stage with Mrs. Maraj. It's Mrs. Maraj, right? Okay, okay, so you're married. Wonderful. We're coming to the point of the presentation of the I might have not wanted that to be the case, you know. Of course, we're going to be inviting, well, they will invite the respective persons to come and hand out these awards, and they will be, of course, announcing the folks to come up. So please, students, trailblazers, fix your collar, fix your corsage. Parents, look at them, make sure it's them all right, because I want any picture I go take. All right? Wonderful. So, I hear there is some award music of some sort. So, Lady Marcia, I turn over to you.
Thank you, Master of Ceremonies. Good afternoon, all. The awardees in the primary category have been selected on the basis of their performances in the 2023 PEP examinations. They have each emerged as the most outstanding PATH student in the region, as identified by Mrs. Witter and her team. Okay. The Region 1 Male Top Achiever hails from the Hope Valley Experimental School and went on to my alma mater, Arden High School, with a PEP score of 346.7 out of a possible 400. P.S. Wisden, may I please invite you to come to the front to hand out these awards. Our primary awardees will receive, in addition to their plaque, they'll each receive a check of $25,000 and a book voucher of similar value. Thank you, Jemaine. No? Now, ladies and gentlemen, also from Region 1, please help me welcome and congratulate Miss Cardelia Zolaka Edwards. She moves from the Dunrobin Primary to the Woolmers Girls School with a score of 333.73. From Region 2, top male awardee from the Ora Cabeza Primary School to St. Mary High with a PEP score of 340, Mr. Andre Antoine Thompson.
The female awardee from Region 2 is Miss Shamelia Hassania Anderson. She was at the Buff Bay Primary and has moved on to the Port Antonio High School with a PEP score of 343.96.
From Region 3, with a score of 329.4 from the Hague Primary School, moving on to Cornwall College, Mr. Chidi Alexius Baker.
Please help me welcome also from Region 3, Miss Evoy Gooden, moving from the Hague Primary to my alma mater, the Westwood High School.
And from Region 4, the top boy, moving from Mount Ward Primary School to Mannings High School with a score of 339, Mr. Temani Amari Miles.
From Region 5, please help me welcome Miss Deidre Ann Althea Graham, who has moved on from the Black River Primary to the Hampton School with a score of 342.3.
And the male top achiever primary from Region 5 with a score of 337 is Mr. Roshane Paris Thomas, who has moved from the Happy Grove Primary to Monroe College.
From Region 6, let us congratulate Miss Gabrielle Novlett Graham with a score of 342.47 from St. Catherine Primary to the Campion College.
And the male winner for Region 6 from Ensom City Primary to Woolmers Boys School with a score of 335 is Mr. Tyree Theodore Barnes. And for Region 7, male top achiever at the primary level, moving from Moravia Primary to the Carteret College with a score of 335, Mr. St. Joseph Bartley. Thank you, Permanent Secretary. At this time, we'd like to welcome Dr. Dunn, our Minister of State, as we present the top scholars at the secondary level. The awardees at the secondary level have been identified on the basis of their 2023 CSEC examinations. And for Region 1, we have from the Campion College a young man who has received who has 9 grade 1 passes at the CSEC, including biology, chemistry, English A and B, geography, information technology, mathematics, physics, and Spanish. Please welcome Mr. Kashif Barton. Kashif and the other secondary winners will receive a cash. So I was saying that our winners at this level will each receive a book voucher valued at $50,000 along with a check of the same value.
Ladies and gentlemen, the female winner from Region 1 is also from the Campion College. She received 9 grade 1s in the 2023 CSEC examinations in biology, chemistry, English A, English B, Information Technology, Mathematics, Principles of Accounts, and Principles of Business. Please help me congratulate Ms. Chanel Umeora.
Ms. Umeora was not able to join us today as she's off the island, and so we are inviting the parish manager for Kingston and St. Andrew, Mr. Vinroy Reed, to accept the award on her behalf. From Region 2, our top male performer from the Paul Bogle High School in St. Thomas has received passes in 7 subjects in the CSEC. He also received an Agriculture Science Single Award for his outstanding performance. He has passes in biology, chemistry, English A and B, physical education, and social studies. I almost said social security. Please help me welcome Mr. Shanoy Lenford Shand. Shanoy also holds leadership positions at his school. He's a prefect, form captain, and monitor.
Our female awardee in Region 2 is from the Marymount High School in St. Mary. She obtained 6 grade 1s and a grade 2 in the CSEC examinations in English A, Human and Social Biology, Information Technology, Mathematics, Office Administration, Principles of Accounts, and Principles of Business. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me congratulate Ms. Abriana Ellis.
From Region 3, we want to welcome the head boy of the Troy High School in Trelawney, who has attained passes in 9 subjects at the CSEC, including 6 grade 1s and 3 grade 2s. Mr. O'Neill Robinson, who is accompanied by his proud father, has passes in agricultural science, biology, chemistry, English A, information technology, mathematics, principles of accounts, principles of business, and social studies.
Our female awardee in Region 2 is from the St. Hilda's Diocesan High School in St. Anne. She acquired 8 grade 1s in the following subjects: biology, English A, English B, information technology, mathematics, principles of business, social studies, and Spanish. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Dervet Minor.
From Region 4, our awardee hails from Cornwall College in St. James. Listen, he has obtained passes in 11 subjects, including 8 grade 1s, 2 grade 2s, and a grade 3. The subjects include additional mathematics, biology, chemistry, English A, human and social biology, information technology, integrated science, mathematics, physical education and sports, physics, and Spanish. Please welcome Mr. Elvis Reed. Elvis is not here. Is this his mom? Sister?
The mom.
Please come along, mommy. And we see your tears of joy. Please make her welcome.
Our female awardee from Region 4 is from the Herbert Morrison Technical High School in St. James. She received 8 grade 1s with straight A profiles in biology, chemistry, English A, food and nutrition, geography, information technology, mathematics, and physics. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Toni Ann Taylor.
From Region 5, our top male achiever is from the Monroe College in St. Elizabeth. He has passes in 8 grade 1 subjects at the CSEC level. We did not get the details as to which subjects they were, but please welcome with us Mr. Winston Brown, Region 1 top achiever.
Our female winner in Region 5 is from the De Carteret College in Manchester. She's a prefect, has matriculated to the sixth form program of the school. She received 9 subjects, including 6 grade 1s and 3 grade 2s in biology, chemistry, English A and B, information technology, mathematics, physics, principles of accounts, and Spanish. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Chelsea Pingy.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are now at Region 6. And this is information which I shared with Minister Charles earlier, but he said he didn't want to say it then. We have an interesting tie in the male awardees for Region 6. The first awardee, and I'll tell you the names in a while, is from the St. Jago High School in St. Catherine. He obtained passes in 8 subjects at the CSEC, including 7 grade 1s and 1 grade 2. The subjects are additional mathematics, chemistry, English A and B, physics, principles of business, and technical drawing. He is a prefect, student manager of the robotics club, and treasurer of the math club. Our second awardee is from the Dintil Technical High School. He also attained passes in 8 subjects at the CSEC exams, including, again, 7 grade 1s and 1 grade 2. His subjects are English A, Family and Resource Management, Food, Nutrition and Health, Human and Social Biology, Integrated Science, Principles of Business, Social Studies and Textiles, Clothing and Fashion. He is the Vice President of the Sixth Form Guild. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me welcome the twin brothers, Javert. So that's Javert and Javert Blake.
Our theme, congratulations for going to Dintil, sir. Our female winner from Region 6 is from the St. Jago High School in St. Catherine. She received 10 subjects, 7 grade 1s and 3 grade 2s in history, human and social biology, English A and B, information technology, mathematics, principles of business, religious education, social studies, and Spanish. Ladies and gentlemen, help me congratulate Miss Gabrielle Howell.
Gabrielle, she's not here. May I invite our parish manager for St. Catherine, Mrs. Stuart Green, to come up and receive the award on her behalf. We move on to Region 7, where our top boy hails from the Alphonsus Davis High School in your parish, minister. This young man received passes in 8 CSEC subjects, including biology, English A, food, nutrition and health, information and technology, mathematics, physical education and sport, religious education, and social studies. Please welcome Mr. Laron Buckle.
Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, the top female in Region 7 is from the Kellett High School in Clarendon. She received 8 CSEC subjects in biology, chemistry, English A, food, nutrition and health, information technology, mathematics, physical education and sports, and physics. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Malika Phillips.
Thank you, Minister Dawn. Thank you for your services. At this time, we invite the Honorable Pernell Charles Jr., Minister of Labor and Social Security, who I see is glowing from pride, to present the other awards. The PATH Top Scholar awardees have emerged as overall most excellent among the top achievers which have just been presented to you. Their nominations are based not only on academic performance, but on the other aspects of their student career. At the primary level, we want to acknowledge the former head boy of the Hope Valley Experimental School, Mr. Jamie Thomas, who is described as having a positive attitude and commitment to the pursuit of excellence. He has had a positive impact on his school community. Jamie received the Top Scholar Trophy. Jamie received the Top Scholar Trophy for most outstanding male student at the primary level and a letter of commendation from the Honorable Minister of Labor and Social Security.
Ladies and gentlemen, our Top Scholar female awardee is a student who was at the Hague Primary and is now at the Westwood High School. She has been described as having an enthusiasm for learning, hard work, and commitment to achieving high academic standards. She receives the Top Scholar Trophy for Most Outstanding Female Student at the primary level for 2023 and a letter of commendation from the Honorable Minister of Labor and Social Security. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Evoy Gooden.
Our top scholar at the secondary level, in addition to the number of subjects which he has passed, serves in his community through involvement with his church, which is the Meadowbrook United Church. He leads devotions and conversations in the summer and other breaks with indigent seniors who come weekly on a Tuesday morning for breakfast. He serves as vice president of the church's youth fellowship, where he endeavors to empower fellow young people to achieve their full potential through the practice of discipline and spiritual engagement. He serves as president of the ISCF for 4 consecutive years and frequently practices in inter-school debate, most recently the Jamaica Association for Debate and Empowerment Region 1 Invitational. Please welcome our top male scholar at the secondary level, Mr. Kashif Barton. Oh, Minister wants me to remind us all that he's from the Campion College.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, our top scholar female at the secondary level is a lower sixth form student at the St. Hilda's Diocesan High School. She describes herself as resilient, determined, hardworking, and self-driven, who pours herself into her academics while participating in extracurricular activities. Her school involvement is as follows: president of the robotics club, secretary of the science club, boarding prefect, deputy form captain, team captain for the first Tech Challenge robotics championship team. She is also a volunteer of CAFE, Citizens Action for Free and Fair Elections. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Dervet Minot.
We welcome back at this point, Dervet, all of our four top scholars. Please join us back on stage.
There's one more.
Yeah. Success has many parents, doesn't it? Thank you, awardees. Minister, we still need you. At this time, we move to the final category of awardees. And these are... These awardees have passed, long past the... Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we want to present the Path Trailblazer nominees. The Trailblazers are former Path beneficiaries. Some of them were top achievers at one point. But these are persons that, through their academic and professional lives, are tangible demonstrators of the long-term impact of Path. These are no longer students, but trailblazers in their own fields. Our first nominee, who is not able to be here today because she tells me that she has recently started a new job, is Miss Samantha Sashana Williams, an employee of the Planning Institute of Jamaica. Among her list of awards and achievements, she has been first place winner. She was placed first in the National Business Model Competition of 2019. She was first place Total Startup of the Year 2018-2019. First place UE Venture Competition 2018-19. Finalist of the Pitch It Competition 2017. Semi-finalist in the International Business Model Competition held at the Microsoft Campus in Washington, Seattle in 2016. She has other accolades, including top undergrad business team, Vincent Osang Youth WI Venture Competition, and she is Miss Samantha Sashana Williams with a long list of accolades. We just want to acknowledge her in her absence and offer a hand of applause. Thank you.
Our second nominee is the Chief Executive Officer of One-on-One Educational Services Limited. In his application, he advised us that One-on-One has emerged as the foremost EdTech company in the Caribbean, harnessing the power of artificial intelligence to deliver personalized education. He's the holder of a Bachelor of Sciences degree in Actuarial Science. He is the recipient of the Youth Leaders of the Americas Fellowship in 2016 and was named the Best Young Entrepreneur of 2015 at the NCB Nation Builder Awards. He has served as an adjunct lecturer at the UWI. He's a member of the Jamaica Stock Exchange Best Practices Committee, chairman of the University of Technology Course Advisory Committee, senior fellow at the Youth Leaders of the Americas program, sponsored by the U.S. Department of State, and several other accolades and accomplishments. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Ricardo Allen.
Minister Charles, we invite you to present to Mr. Allen our token of recognition. Mr. Allen, will you please join us on stage? So Mr. Allen is being presented with an original piece of art and a letter of commendation from our minister. No, please stay with the minister. Our final nominee for Path Trailblazer has expressed a commitment to service and leadership, which began early in his career. The zenith of his achievements was his role in optimizing operations for a $46 million project in Kalamazoo City in Michigan. He lists among his many, many, many accolades, list of awards: Faculty of Science and Technology winner of the 3-minute thesis competition in 2021. He had his MPhil program upgraded to a PhD for research on the ackee seed starch, and I'm skipping some of them. He's second place winner of the 28th Mona Symposium for Natural Products and Medicinal Chemistry. Faculty of Science and Technology Dean's Honor Roll for 2016, Fellow of the Youth Leaders of America 2023, Technical Secretary, Biodegradable Plastic Technical Committee of 2019-2020. Details of his community impact: he has optimized and streamlined revenues and operations for that $46 billion project. He is commandant of the Commendation Medal 2022. He is the recipient of both the Prime Minister's Youth Award for Excellence and the Governor General's Achievement Award 2019, PhD candidate of the Mona UWI campus. Please welcome with us Please welcome our third nominee. Pierce, I'm excited. And winner of the PATH 2024 Trailblazer Award, Mr. Jordan Luther Freeman. Jordan now receives the trophy for top trailblazer. He also receives his piece of artwork. And a citation
from the Ministry of Labor and Social Security. Jordan. Yes. At this time, we welcome back on stage our Permanent Secretary and Minister of State. Would you please join us on stage? Mr. Freeman, please do not leave. We also welcome back at this time Mr. Allen. Please come to join us on stage. Thank you, ministers. Ladies and gentlemen, it is being pointed out that we overlooked a couple of our nominees or awardees. Miss Candestina Mendez, who earlier graced us with that lovely piece, would you please join us on stage? Minister Dunn, would you please, can we ask you to come back to present these awards? Miss Chevenise Brown of the Manning School. And the third awardee, Miss Aisha Porter. Aisha Porter was from the Sunbury All-Age School and has moved to Decatur College. Thank you, awardees. Thank you, Minister Dunn. Thank you, Mrs. Mirage. This is the end of the presentation of awards.
Thank you so very much for those presentations. I got goosebumps. Did you? I was filled with joy. Were you? Wonderful. Ladies and gentlemen, it is quite interesting, and it allows one to pulsate with pride when it comes on to these events. A celebration of our nation's youth, our nation's children, who are the leaders and shapers of tomorrow. Please put your hands together for every single one of them. The Program of Advancement Through Health and Education is literally leading the path to a better Jamaica. Clap again. And so events like these, stories like these, testimonies like these must be shared across the length and breadth of Jamaica to encourage people that, because, you know, as I look at the diversity of the students who come up, you can see the humility on them. When I look at the face of the parents, you can see them beaming with pride because they understand the stories of lack of resources. They understand the stories of lack of opportunities. And so they dress up from early this morning, take bus, taxi, car, beg, drive, or drive themselves and come. Because this is a culmination of their efforts. And I'm really proud with you. And I can see the faces of the folks who labor in the ministry of how proud they are when it comes down to processing those checks, those benefits. You know, when it comes, Sophie, I have to clap in because she's in the finance department. Eh? You know, when it comes down to those, I know the ministry business is not because they help grow me. Right. So I understand CTD, the challenges that you have to mitigate every day. And I could just envisage PS walking through the challenges and making sure that she meets solutions to those challenges to ensure that those students are able to progress and do well. I'm wondering, PS, I left my program. Thank you so much. Ah, wonderful. So, to tell you thanks in a very formal way and not leave out anybody, I'm going to invite my friend, the dearest, Mrs. Audrey Dare Williams, Chief Technical Director for the Social Security Division, to join me on stage to bring the vote of thanks. But, I was just trying to relax, no man. But, before she gives the vote of thanks, it's quite important to get a response from those who have gone the way and continue to show the way, our path trailblazer for 2024. Please, sir, join me on stage.
Honorable Minister, distinguished guests, fellow awardees, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. It is with great honor that I stand before you today to present the response on behalf of my fellow trailblazers and PATH awardees. The program of advancement through health and education PATH, now in its 22nd year of existence, continues to level the playing field. Author Debbie Irvin once said, "Sharing the burden of social discomfort is not simply a matter of helping someone else feel good. It is about leveling the playing field in pursuit of nurturing individual and collective potential." This is what the PATH program means to its beneficiaries and the many awardees present here today. By leveling the playing field, you have given us a PATH, which is also an acronym for purpose. You have enabled us to look beyond our difficult circumstances and strive for a better future. A, access. You have provided us with the resources and support we need to pursue and achieve our dreams. T, time. You have helped us to understand and appreciate that is not where or when we started in this race of life we can achieve greatness. And H, honor. You have given us the opportunity to demonstrate that we are great, upstanding, and accomplished in our own rights. Thank you for leveling the playing field. My fellow awardees, we are here today as recipients of these awards because we have worked hard, we have sacrificed a lot, and we have resisted taking the easy and sometimes bad way out of trying situations. We are here because we made use of the opportunities and support provided to us to ensure that we become better and more successful versions of ourselves and those we represent. We are here because we have made ourselves, our family, our teachers, our peers, the Ministry of Labor and Social Security, and all other stakeholders proud. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for the awardees, please. Thank you. In closing, it is imperative that we zoom in and highlight the tremendous growth and support of the PATH program. To all members of Ministry of Labor and Social Security, especially the coordinating staff, the selection committee, and all other stakeholders who continue to work tirelessly to deliver hope and support to the beneficiaries, thank you. The Ministry of Labor and Social Security has gone beyond just providing us with access. You have elevated your commitment to us through initiatives such as PATH,
such as the PATH Trailblazer Awards, where you recognize the vast beneficiaries like me who have achieved great feats at their various levels, and while showcasing to current and future beneficiaries to embrace the support available as there is light at the end of the tunnel and through the support of PATH. They too can become the best versions of themselves. Congratulations to all award recipients and the Minister of Labour and Social Security on a job well done. Thank you.
Thank you so very much, our trailblazer. I want you to know, so earlier we had a little hiccup, and that happens sometimes, right? Some of our invited guests who are top achievers, regrettably, we were not able, as you can see, to have them within the batch. But we tried to mitigate against that. I just want those awardees to know that their information is here with the accolades that are accorded to you that allowed you to get a seat at this event today. I must express my sincerest apologies for that earlier oversight, and I would love for you to appreciate that we appreciate you, and I apologize again for not being able to describe in a very descriptive way, as the others, your individual achievements. But what I will do for you, especially for you three awardees that were called on at the later time, is to ask for a rousing round of applause for all your, and please come back up. All of you, and I'm going to ask that the ministers join you on stage. This is unconventional. This is, I'm a PR specialist, you know, man. Yes. And tell me, you transitioned from?
Primary school.
To?
Manning's High School.
Manning's High. Okay, and you did PEP, right? Tell me your PEP score.
I don't remember.
That's all right. And you came from?
Old Abrahai School. I did CXC.
Oh, tell me about your CXCs.
Well, I got 8 range ones and 1 range 2.
All right. Hello. Tell me where I guess you're in first form. Tell me what school you came from.
I'm Sunbury Primary.
Okay, and you know your PEP score?
No.
But she went. She's going to Decartret. That's all that you can say in it. She did well, not you. Wonderful. So please, ladies and gentlemen, give them a round of applause. Mommy, yes, you hear what I go on? The subject then that you labor with her to say, make sure say, study. Not true. Wonderful. Thank you so very much. The ministry prides itself in ensuring that no one gets left behind. It's a principle that we not only talk, but we demonstrate it. And our ministers and PS are flag bearers of that mandate, ensuring that everybody feels special and feel good. Thank you so very much, everyone. Earlier, I told you about someone who was and is very dear to me. You know, somehow I feel like she does not like the lectern, but that's okay. Madam Dear Williams, please put your hands together for her as she brings a vote of thanks, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Mr. Master of Ceremonies. Actually, I was wondering who told you that I needed extra time to get up here. Okay. Mr. Master of Ceremonies, Honorable Pernell Charles Jr., Dr. the Honorable Norman Dunn, and I believe we had a representative of Minister Tufton, I'm not sure he's still here, our Permanent Secretary, Mrs. Roberts Risden, and P.S. Denzel Thorpe is now in the house. (Laughter) We have representatives from the UN and UNICEF, PIOJ, representatives of other partner entities, distinguished awardees, parents, principals, guidance counselors, teachers, my colleagues from the Ministry of Labor and Social Security. Good afternoon. Thank you. Thank you. I know we're ready to go, but just bear with me a few more minutes. I promise you I won't be long. At the Ministry of Labor and Social Security, our tagline is providing opportunity, stability, and social protection. Today's event is a prime example of just how we live that vision. I often say to my team that we do real ministry at Ministry of Labor and Social Security. We are God's hands and feet in this Jamaica land we love. What a difference it makes when you make use of the opportunities that come your way. Anyway, I'm not here to preach this afternoon, so let me get on with my task. It is often said that all good things must come to an end. And as we bring the curtains down on this momentous occasion, I can say with confidence that we all had a good time, right? It is my honor and privilege to express on behalf of the MLSS heartfelt thanks to everyone who has no doubt made this event not only possible, but also deeply memorable. We have always known of the power of PATH as an instrument of empowerment and social mobility. Today, as a person at the helm of the Social Security Division, I can say with pride that notwithstanding the challenges, and our master ceremonies mentioned some, here is the proof, Jamaica, that your investment in the future leaders of the nation has produced and will continue to produce huge returns. PATH beneficiaries are doing well and will continue doing that and have positive impact on their lives. I am sure we have all been inspired and encouraged by what we have heard and seen today. Thank you to all our distinguished awardees, guests, and the partners of the PATH program who made great effort to be here today. Your presence and support have been instrumental in the success of today's ceremony. But your contributions go so much further than an occasional appearance at a function. By your daily support to the program, whether at the strategic or operational level, you make incremental investments in the future of our beneficiaries as they strive to create a better world through education. While she has already left, let me at this point say thanks to Honorable Favour Williams, Minister of Education and Youth, for having taken some time out of what we know is a busy schedule to be with us here with us today to celebrate the successes of our awardees. We are also immensely grateful to our team here at the ministry, our ministers, permanent secretary, the organizing team. I'm going to let you into a little secret. I called Mrs. Bolt-Williams after 8 last night, and she was still busy at it at North Street. All our volunteers and all who work behind the scenes to ensure the smooth execution of this event. To our guests of honor, the reason we are all gathered here today, our award recipients, our achievers, our trailblazers, we laud you. Your hard work, discipline, perseverance have not only earned you this recognition, but you have also set examples for your peers to follow. Keep shining. Keep inspiring. Congratulations. To the families and supporters of our achievers, we also applaud you. Your encouragement, belief, and sacrifices have made their journey to this day possible. Continue to be a source of motivation for them. Certainly, a big thank you to the staff here at the Spanish Court Hotel. You have provided a beautiful environment which has set the tone for a lovely occasion. For this, we are grateful. To our master of ceremonies, our entertainers, and we got a bonus entertainer, our media technicians, ushers, just about everyone present. This ceremony would not have been the success it has been without your support and enthusiasm. Thank you. I also want to thank the media, which has been with us all during this event. Of course, none of this would be possible without God. And so we thank Parish Manager Michelle Sr. for starting us on the right path. I hope you got that this morning. To God be the glory. In closing, as we continue to celebrate empowerment through education, let us all be reminded of the profound power of learning and the doors that it opens for every individual. Together, we can all change lives and build a brighter Jamaica. Thank you all, and may God continually bless you. Get home safely and walk good.
We are ending where we started. What a vote of thanks. I think that was being prepared from the function last year. Yes, man, it was well done, Madam Dear Williams. Thank you so very much for that, for ensuring that no one got left behind. For those who are joining us online, thank you so very much for keeping company with us. We hope that you enjoyed the ceremony, and I'm for certain that you have somebody in this room who is receiving an award. So kudos to you. Thank you for joining us. For our media partners who are here from the RGR, Gleaner Group, Power 106, who was with us, thank you so very much. The event would not be able to reach some length and breadth and nook and crannies of Jamaica without you. So thank you so very much. Ladies and gentlemen, it was my absolute pleasure to take you through the program. I hope you had a wonderful time with us this afternoon. Did you? One kind of belly full. but even more so, we are inspired by the stories of excellence from our young people and our trailblazers. They inspire us all to lead better lives. Thank you so very much. My name is Roger Danvers, and if I did this well, I will see you next year, same time, perhaps another place. What good. Right, I'm hoping that the stream is down now. Do God, please, come and wash yourself. Okay, so considering that the stream is now down, I can't get into a TikTok business in a man. Right, so some housekeeping matters. So for the awardees, I'm going to ask all of you to listen to the following instructions. Very important. Now, firstly, I want all the awardees, including the trailblazers, so secondary, well, primary and secondary and trailblazers, our photo opportunities. Thereafter, you will proceed left to the table over there to receive.
Hi, my name is Anissa McFarlane. With the help of the funds that my family and I received from PAS, my siblings and I were able to attend school, obtain good meals, and prepare for the start of each year. Now, this is from primary to high school, including sixth form, and lasts approximately 13 years in all. PAS not only helped there, but after completing my CSEC and CAPE examinations, and I did great, of course, I was actually able to obtain a scholarship that definitely assisted me financially in university. My family and I are grateful to PAT for all the help that we received. I endorse the path to transformation.
Good morning. My name is Dr. Makeda Bailey, and I come from very humble beginnings. My father, a farmer, and my mother, a stay-at-home mom. Love them both dearly. I ended sixth form knowing that I wanted to study medicine, right? However, having come from very humble beginnings, there was that financial burden on my shoulder, wondering if I could afford the tuition. But glory to God, I was granted the PAT scholarship, and it aided phenomenally in me completing medical school. I was able to take less student loans, and I have less money to pay student loan and more money in my pocket, and I was able to go through medical school without having that financial burden, you know. And I'm just extremely grateful to the PAT committee and for the help that they were able to provide in letting a little country girl's dreams come true. So I fully endorse the PAT to transformation.
Yeah, good day. My name is Ramon Thomas. I'm here to tell you guys that I'm a proud beneficiary of the PAT program. This program have done a tremendous job for me and my family over the years going to the Portmore Archers NTA. And in addition to that, the PAT program has also done a tremendous job for me as well by granting me a business grant. This program did such a good thing for me when I was training at the Art College of Construction Service in Portmore, where I was doing a welding level 3 and a diploma in drywall construction, which they gave me $600 Jamaican per week. It was tremendous for me during those times of difficulty when there is no help. My family could not give me any support. The PAT program helped me a lot. This benefit that the PAT program gave to me has done so much for me, including at this moment speaking to you guys. I'm currently in the UK working as a skilled worker in welding and pipe fitting. I endorse the PAT program in Jamaica doing such a wonderful job, and hope they could do this for many more young youths.
Good day, everybody. Greetings to all. My name is Zachary Campbell, and I am a final year electrical engineering student at the University of Technology. You know, PAT has always been a very integral part of my scholastic journey. You know, my earliest memories of PAT dates back to high school, where I benefited from various initiatives associated with PAT. For instance, the lunch program, and also being able to do all of the external exams that was required for me to transition from one stage to the next. You know, PAT was also instrumental during my time at university, where the substantial fees associated with, you know, going to school was greatly alleviated by me being recipients of grants and various scholarships under the Ministry of Labour, associated with the PAT program. And that's why I am fully endorse, you know, the PAT to transformation.
Okay, so there might be a space of background noise. My name is Brittany Monroe, and I'm here to talk about how PAT has helped me in my journey of becoming a pharmacist. And today I can't forget receiving the acceptance letter, and my aunt would always paid for school fees and all that. She came to me and she said that she's not sure if she'll be able to help in the way that she always has been able to help. So immediately I knew that I had to go and source scholarships, and I did a good amount, I think a handful. And I just remember receiving an email from PAT, and they were the only one to help fund my journey. So I want to say thanks, and I endorse the path to transformation.